Hey everyone, it's Justin again. We said in the last video that the best thing about having three interchangeable forms is that you can choose which form to use. In this video, we're going to be practicing that skill, using the same information to write all three forms. We now know how to write, interpret, and graph all three linear forms. But since they can all be used to express the same lines, we can manipulate the terms to change back and forth between all three. Usually it's easiest to start with the form indicated by the given information. For instance, this problem gives us 2 points. And since neither point is an intercept, we'll use the form designed for any point on the line, point slope form. If we calculate the slope between the points, we get -1/2, and we can use either point for the equation. So let's just go with the first one. Here's the equation we get. But what if we want it in slope-intercept or standard form? The defining feature for slope-intercept form is that the y is isolated. So let's just solve the equation for y. Distribute the -1/2, and then add 3 to both sides. The slope-intercept form for this equation is y equals -1/2 x plus 2. Now, if we wanted it in standard form instead, we need to manipulate it so that x and y are on one side and constants are on the other. So first we distribute, and then we add 1/2 x just to move it to the left, and then we add 3 to move it to the right. Now we just need to make the fraction an integer by multiplying everything by 2. So in standard form, this equation is x plus 2y equals 4. All three of these equations look completely different, but they're actually just manipulations of each other. They're actually the same, representing the same line. For this example, one of the points we have is the y-intercept. So we'll start with slope-intercept form first. The slope comes out to 3. And if we combine that and the y-intercept, we get that the equation is y equals 3x plus 1. If we want this in standard form instead, we subtract 3x to the other side, then change all the signs so that the x's coefficient is positive. So the standard form for this equation is 3x minus y equals -1. For point slope form, we just use the information we already know, which is the slope and any point, which can include the y-intercept. Then we simply plug those points into point slope form, and we get that y minus 1 equals 3 times x minus 0. This equation has been given in words, but if we write it as an algebraic equation, we get this: the sum of x and 2y tripled is equal to 18. It's pretty easy to see that if we distribute the 3, we get an equation in standard form. We can convert this to either of the other forms. For slope-intercept, we need to isolate the y, so just subtract 3x to the other side and then divide by 6. The slope-intercept form of this equation is y equals -1/2x plus 3. For the point-slope version, we can use the information we just found, that the slope is -1/2, and that the y-intercept of 3 gives us a point to use. If we use those in point slope form, we get the equation y minus 3 equals -1/2 times x minus 0. Changing between the three forms is easy once you understand how they're related to each other. In the next lesson, we're going to finish out this unit by applying all three linear equations forms to real-world scenarios. Word problems. Hey, hey.